New polling shows Queensland Labor closing the gap on the LNP. Now just 46 days from the state election, Queensland political reporter Harry Clark joins us from State Parliament, where the final sitting week is underway. I think this poll might have grabbed a bit of attention among the MPs.
Well, it has, Kieran, and indicates that the government's pre-election cost of living sweeteners, such as the 50-cent fares, the $1,000 energy rebates, may be working, particularly in the metropolitan areas. However, even factoring in the 3% margin for error, the LNP is still very much in a winning position ahead of the election on October 26. Here are the figures. The polling was carried out by Redbridge for the Nine Network. They show that on a two-party preferred basis, the LNP is at 45.5%. That's down 2.5% since the previous poll in May. The ALP, 45.5%, up 2.5% since May. When it comes to the primary vote, the LNP is at 42%. That's down 5%. The ALP, 29%, up 1% since May. Now, what's interesting is these figures are virtually identical to news poll figures that were published in March, but they fly in the face of separate polling carried out today by Nine newspapers showing that the LNP has actually extended its two-party preferred lead. This one's also interesting. The ALP has a huge two-party preferred lead in inner and middle suburbs of Brisbane, 63% on a two-party preferred basis to the ALP in metropolitan areas over the LNP's 37%. So it indicates that when you consider that broader statewide two-party preferred polling, that the ALP is in significant strife in regional Queensland. We have just begun the final sitting week of Parliament before the government enters caretaker mode and on October 1. And if those polls are anything to go by, Kieran, we might expect to see a lot of Premier Stephen Miles up and down regional Queensland, particularly around those marginal areas of Rockhampton, Townsville and Cairns.
Harry, thanks so much for that. Appreciate it.